Mandy, and I'm going to play you some songs. Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Birds drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life.
EastEnders.
Sorry. I'll wait for you. I'm here too. My name's Mandy. If you don't know, there's a lot of people who do, so hello to those. And I'm sorry. I do covers, but I also do originals. I'm going to do a lot of that tonight. And this is my first one. I wrote this about a year ago, just feeling like a bit weird, which you wouldn't expect.
No,
people who know me.
We would.
But this is a little song about the weirdos and the wonderfuls that I believe that are my tribe. So this is this is called Junk Pile. Passionate, slightly unhinged, a noise is what they feel. you can tell, I'm really into new metal. I love new metal. You know, the Biscuit, Flippin and all that. But my favourite band that were out at the time was Linkin Park. So I thought maybe I'd do a Linkin Park song on the ukulele. Everyone nervously laughs because they're really not sure how to take what I've just said to them. That's all right. We've got just about an hour of this madness, and you're going to go, didn't realise the beer at the Flippin Frog was that strong.
Ukulele.
Lazy guitar.
Nice track.
Thanks.
Lovely
track.
Got
not the brightest tracks.
Yes,
well,
I bet you have.
Oh, right.
She said about the strings. Well,
guitar.
Four strings with guitar, eh?
Yeah, that's what she did. I believe she now needs to lie.
this song is a very good friend of mine used to live quite close and moved away and was really anxious about it for ages. And it was totally the right thing. It was totally the right thing for her to do, to move away and to make a bit of a time for herself. And it was, but it was a really hard time for her. So I wrote this with her in mind. And this is called Distance. Okay, try that again. Oops. And it was from a band that was big in the 90s, and it was fronted by Gwen Stefani before she was rubbish. And I like the words. This is I'm Just a Girl.
Just
I'm such a shy, retiring flower. I'm sure you're getting that kind of feel from me. I do a lot of theatre as well as just being a musician. Jazz, fully experienced in jazz hands, grade 8. Sometimes you can get on with people and sometimes you don't. And sometimes behind the scenes it doesn't always work as well as you hope. But there's always solace in the fact that you're on stage and you're having a really good time. So this is all about this, and this is called Lights. And then they look at her and she's got like this little bit of yogurt on the tip of her nose. And then they all laugh at her, like she's really funny. And she, oh, it's Nicole, it's fine. I don't like it because the last time I fell over holding yogurt, I didn't look as attractive. cold shirt singer. In Margate. Woo! I'm big in Margate. And I was with I'm happy to say this, I was with a class of girls who every night would go, oh my god, let's go get the Prosecco!
Say that now, because you're not going back.
Yeah, exactly. Well, we'll see.
Oh, okay.
Hang on.
It's a long way to go if you're not going to be.
I better cut that way, cut that bit out of the video.
This is one of the first songs I ever wrote, and it's really special for me. And it's called Forever and a Day, and I really like it, so enjoy. I missed you in the crowd, but I know we it somehow and never let each other go. Forever and a day. I'm not going to give it an introduction. I'm just going to go for it and close my eyes and hope for the best.
Got to be mine, isn't it?
It's easy.
Call me up at me. Oh. opera-lely. So we sing opera and we play ukuleles. Something to do, innit? So that's just a little thing that normally I do with my singing partner, but he's not here, so that was my little attempt at...
We are going to get Opera Lely down here in a few months' time.
Yes.
Oh, yes. It's going to be packed.
Yeah.
So, we'll have an hour of shenanigans up in ours. So, yes, do look out for it, because we'll be back and it'll be fun. Good. A lot of people say that I look like...
Oh, God.
Some people say that I look like a certain pop star. I get stopped everywhere I go.
Mick Jagger.
No, the other one.
You spoiled it now. I look like a certain pop star. I get stopped everywhere about it. And I know. I look like Beyonce.
Astonishment everywhere.
I really do. So, in honour of the fact that me and Beyonce are pretty close, I'm going to sing the song.
She don't do
that
the mid-late.
That was sung by Beyonce.
She don't do the mid-late.
She don't do the mid-late now.
Anyway, this is a song by Beyonce.
So, if you liked it, you should have put a ring on it. So, what is he talking about? Is she talking about just her finger? If you liked my finger, you should have put a ring on it. Which then brings in all sorts of questions what ring this is. My mind works.
Next song.
That whole song, I was just... My mind wasn't quite on it, if I'm honest.
That's pop music for you.
Maybe we should have a class on dissecting pop music 101 and come up with lots.
Basically, pop music is a finger up the bum hole.
Oh, no.
Damn it, something else I've got to edit out.
Quote of the night. Hashtag bum hole. Oh, right. I want to do another song.
Quick.
And there's, I hope there's no reference to bum holes in this. If you find it and start laughing, please stop. A couple of years ago, I had a really hard time with, I dislocated my back and I slipped a disc and my life kind of all fell apart and it was all a bit rough. I got through it and I'm on the other side. But the New Year's Eve leading up, since I'd had all of this, was sort of a moment for me to go, okay, fresh start, let's go, you know. And I wrote this song about it. And I guess with everything that's been going on lately, it has new meaning. So it should be called 4 years, but it's not. This is called Next Year. Sung until the end of time, and others So, I play the ukulele.
No.
Really?
Yeah, I know. There's a lot of people here who know what a ukulele is. But sometimes, when you go to a pub and you produce your little instrument, some people in the pub will laugh at you. Which I don't know why people would laugh at a small instrument.
Fiona does, don't you? Okay. I've got a ukulele.
Well, it's got very awkward again, isn't it? Lovely. Anyway, I wrote the next song because I got annoyed with these people because I kept on being asked the same questions over and over again, and I thought, you know what, I'll just condense it all into one little song so I can say, there you go, shut up, sit down, drink your beer. So, this is called Frequently Asked Questions About Ukulele, but I shorten it down to FAQ. Enjoy. No, this is not a banjo and it's not a mandolin. No trip to Specsavers required, please let me fill you in. I'm playing what's called a ukulele and it seems to cause such grief. Yes, I play it with my heart and soul and not for comedy relief. And no, my guitar didn't shrink in the wash. Oh, yes, I see you smirk and comment on my children's toy. Tell me, learn a proper instrument. It gets me tad annoyed. And no, don't tell me in your drunken state how superior you are. Cause you play six strings in a rock band, so four won't get me far. And no, my guitar didn't shrink in the wash. No, don't ask me when I'll move on and learn guitar. Cause beyond your comprehension, I enjoy the uke by far. And no one needs to hear me play when I'm cleaning windows. So don't ask, it's not big or clever. And it's just a fucking bore.
One over there is tuned.
All right.
That yeah. Baritone.
Right, what am I doing next? Oh.
Wow.
I've been trying to see.
Everyone's being political at the moment, so I'm not. I'm not going to be political at all, but I am going to sing this song. Yeah. We're not gonna take it. No, we ain't gonna take it. We're not gonna take it anymore. We're not gonna take it. Oh no, we ain't gonna take it. We're not gonna take it anymore. We got the right to choose and song.
What is it?
Shit! I used to be in a girl band and we wrote this song and I love it and I still play it now because it reminds me of a very good time. This is all about when you perform in a show and the show finishes and everyone's got like the after show blues and they don't really know what to do with themselves. So this is called Curtain Call. Hope you enjoy.
One was the last one. And more!
Okay, I'll do one more. I'd like to say thank you to the wonderful bar staff. Thank you. And thank you, Davey, for booking me. You're amazing. Thank you. Little cover to finish, but a little unusual version. Took 'em in my train of it, and very much, everybody. Woo!